رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم فإني أؤمن بذلك أنا وأبو بكر وعمر. هذا الحديث أخرجه الإمام البخاري أيضا في صحيحه في كتاب فضائل الصحابة، ولا في كتاب الأنبياء، وأخرج مسلم في صحيح أيضا في كتاب فضائل الصحابة. This is the book of Adab al-Mufrad, chapter 402. The ruling of a man saying, Subhanallah, glory be to Allah, when he is amazed. Means what's the ruling of saying Subhanallah, which means glory be to Allah, when you are amazed with something. Some people, they say other things. They may say, oh my goodness, and the like. Instead of that, what is the rule of saying Subhanallah when you are amazed with something? Abu Huraira radiallahu ta'ala anhu said, I heard the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam say, while a shepherd was herding his sheep, a wolf came and took one of the sheep. The shepherd went after the wolf, returned to him and said, who will look after them on the day of wild beasts? They will have no shepherd but me. People said, Subhanallah, glory be to Allah. The Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, I believe it. I and Abu Bakr and Umar. This hadith is also in the Sahih al-Bukhari, the big book, and also it is in the Sahih of Imam Muslim. So it's one of the most authentic hadith. And we know that the authentic hadith is sound hadith is itself has stages and levels. Some are more stronger than the other. Naam. So this hadith is from those most authentic hadiths. In this hadith, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam mentioned that incident that a man was with his animal, with his sheep. And the dhi'ib, the wolf, took one of it. The man chased him, went after the wolf. And then the wolf talked to the man. Talked to the man. Wolf talking? Yes, he did talk. And he said to the man, who will look after them, means after the sheep, on the day of wild beasts? No one but me. They will have no shepherd but me. When the Prophet ﷺ mentioned this incident and the talk of that wolf to the man in this way, they suddenly said, Subhanallah. Subhanallah. This is what the Sahaba said. Glory be to Allah. Which means, Subhanallah, how this big thing happened? Animal, sheep talking to a human being. Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam answered back, saying, I believe it. I and Abu Bakr and Umar. Regardless how to you is so big that sheep speak, but I believe it, Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam said. Also Abu Bakr believe it and Umar believe it. Subhanallah. Imam Muslim, and he mentioned this hadith in his sound, Sahih, and Imam Nawawi rahimahullah made the title, because he's the one who makes the title, made the title of Sahih Muslim. Unlike Imam Bukhari, he made the title for his for the chapters of his book. This is one of the things that Sahih al-Bukhari is different than Sahih Muslim. Sahih al-Bukhari, Imam Bukhari, in this book, he divided into 97 books in itself. Each book is about an issue. Like the book he mentioned in this hadith is Kitab al-Anbiya, the book of the prophets. Imam Bukhari, he made the kitab, then he made the titles. And the understanding of Imam Bukhari in those hadith is in the chapter, in the title. Fiqh al-Bukhari fi tarajumihi. This is what the ulama, they say. Imam Bukhari's understanding of the hadith is in his tarjama. And ulama benefit so much because rahimahullah, sometimes subhanallah, he has very deep understanding. You don't know how he found out this meaning from the hadith. So as for Imam Muslim rahimahullah, he mentioned the hadith and make it follow one another, but the title was made by one of those shurrah, one of those who explained the Sahih Muslim. Is Imam Nawawi rahimahullah has the best explanation for Sahih Muslim we know up to now. Even though Imam Nawawi has some, rahimahullah, had some mistakes in the interpretation of Asma wa Sifat in some times. Therefore, even though he was Ahl Sunnah, but as for that mistake, the ulama, they enlightened. They mentioned it without talking about the Imam himself, because that's all he, rahimahullah ta'ala, could done. So Imam Bukhari, he mentioned, Imam Nawawi, he made that title, yeah, the title of this hadith, and he made Kitab Fada'il al-Sahaba, the virtue of the companion. How Imam Nawawi found the virtue of the companion in this hadith? Who companion he mean? Abu Bakr and Umar. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam mentioned something to be amazed with. Animal talking, sheep talking, a wolf, jazakallah khair, sorry, wolf talking to the man, to the shepherd. So the some of the Sahaba, they say, subhanallah. And this is why Imam Bukhari in this Adab al-Mufrad, why he brought this hadith, is this part, to say the rule of saying subhanallah when you're amazed with something. When you're amazed. Not only my goodness or my such, ila, subhanallah. Be glad to Allah. And the Sahaba, they used to say this word. If you remember, there are other incidents. They say subhanallah. Do you remember one of it? One night, Prophet ﷺ, one time he was making i'tikaf, and one of his wives, Safiya bint Huyay, visited him alayhi salam while he was in the masjid making i'tikaf. And from the sunnah of the Messenger ﷺ and his good manner, if someone visit him, to yani from his welcoming, from the welcome of Prophet ﷺ to the one who visited him, even to go with him a little bit. Not just you close the door, go on your way. You know your way, la. He said, salam, go by. Yani, until the person leaves. You know someone talk about? Like someone visit you to your house. Okay, he is now leaving. You go with him to the by the door. Or by the street, you go with him. This is a type of welcoming. Unlike you are on your chair and you say, okay, you know the door where it is? Yes, go out. La, you don't do that. Al-Muhim, you didn't commit a sin if you do that, alhamdulillah. But it's better to make that So one night Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم was visited by his wife Safiya رضي الله تعالى عنها أم المؤمنين. And when he was by the door and it was dark night, some of two Sahaba, two companions, saw the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم. And they literally go faster. They go. It's like they're running. They go faster. Prophet ﷺ, he said, by Allah, it's Safiya. Wallah, it's Safiya. Means it's my wife. She's my wife. The Sahaba, they said, Subhanallah. This is the point. Subhanallah, they said. Then Prophet ﷺ mentioned why he said that. It was from his wisdom, alayhi salam, and ilm. He said, it's my wife. He said, I fear shaitan goes in the people through where the blood goes, through the vein. So I scare that he may throw something in your heart. You understand that? So, and this is a proof, a Muslim, to remove the doubtful mar from himself. Even though the origin is to think good about the Muslim. To think good about the Muslim. But even that, if it happen, remove from yourself from what you can of doubtful matter. Don't say, I don't care about what people say. Because if people think bad about you, well, they have no right, you're good, they're committing sin. إِنَّ بَعْضَ ظَنُّ إِثْمٌ إِيَّاكَ وَالظَّنُّ They're thinking bad. And they're committing sin. Because you're not allowed to think bad about a Muslim. The origin is to think good about him. Rather, the origin is not only you think good about Muslim, you even defend. Someone say bad about him, you defend. That's the origin. As Allah mentioned in the Quran, وَلَوْلَا إِذْ سَمِعْتُمُوهُ ظَنَّ الْمُؤْمِنُونَ وَالْمُؤْمِنَاتُ بِأَنفُسِهِمْ خَيْرًا. When if you heard it, when you heard it, if you would, if the believers would have think good about one another, so that is the origin. One of the time, Prophet ﷺ was some with his Sahaba, one of the companions didn't come with the battlefield, didn't come out from Medina, come from Medina. Prophet ﷺ said, "Where is such and such?" One of the Sahaba said something that means he busy with worldly life, something like that. Another one said, "Bisa ma qult." Evil is what you said. Wallahi, we only know Adam Safallah about that one, and we only know good about him. We only know good about him. How you say this? So the one who you know good about him, the origin is to remain that goodness until you see the opposite. And not easily someone you know good about him, easily is being destroyed. And the munafiqun, they do this. The shaitan, he does this to discredit the believer. So he divides the Muslims. So this gate is closed. Evil is what you say. Don't say this about it. I know only good about it. Naam. So the Sahaba, the Prophet ﷺ, in other incidents, the Sahaba, they said this word, Subhanallah. So in this hadith that says, Subhanallah, for what you amaze with, is the sunnah لتقرير النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم لها. Because the Messenger he affirmed that this how is the sunnah. If you hear, is the way of the Prophet, which means قوله وفعله وتقريره, something which is done in front of the Prophet, he hears, he sees it, he hears it, he let it go. He didn't say no, don't do this, don't say this. Because Subhanallah, Prophet Muhammad, one of his way, he never leave off something wrong being done, being said without correcting it. It never happened. لأنه لا يجوز تأخير البيان عن وقت الحاجة. Prophet said, he never leave someone doing something wrong, something saying something wrong, someone saying something, and he let it go without being something, without being corrected. So the ulama, they took this, that if something is said, something is done, and Prophet he aware of it, and he didn't object it, is to be mother allowed. So this is the Sahaba here, they said, Subhanallah, those two companions, And this Sahaba in this hadith, they say, Subhanallah, when they heard this information, a wolf talking to a man, Prophet ﷺ, he affirmed that. He didn't say, don't say Subhanallah. But he, ﷺ, Subhanallah, with his, alayhi salam, Iman, sound, creed Iman, unshakable Iman. Then after him, alayhi salam, he mentioned Abu Bakr and Umar. Regardless how to be so amazed, Prophet said, I believe that wolf talked to a human being. And Abu Bakr believed it, and Umar believed it. Allahu Akbar. Munafiq, Rafida. Rafida, the Shia, and the Munafiqun. With all these sound narrations, astaghfirullah, they still believe, a'udhu billah, and say, Abu Bakr was not a true believer, Umar was not a true believer. A'udhu billah. Wallahi, that belies the Quran and the Sunnah. Talking about the companion, it belies the Quran and Sunnah. No one can believe the Quran and Sunnah truly without loving the companion Prophet. Loving them, the companion is wallahi from the Iman. The enemy of Al Islam, Quran is straight attack the Quran and the Prophet himself. So what they did, they say, let we attack those who carry, who are human beings, who are meanies, not ma'asumun. And the Muslims, they accepted that Abu Bakr is not ma'asum. He's a human being. He may mistake. He may not know. He's Abu Bakr, he's Umar. Through that, let we talk about Islam itself. So don't take it light. Someone talking about ماذا the Sahaba رضوان الله تعالى عليهم about their deen, about. So Prophet ﷺ here he's saying, I believe it regardless how to you is so great. That means and Abu Bakr believe it and Umar believe it. Prophet ﷺ يشهد لأبي بكر وعمر أنهما مؤمنان بهذا الحديث, that they believe this hadith. They are not amazed with. رضوان الله تعالى عليهم. Oh, you may say, you know what? Masam Salam didn't know that. Masam Salam, he doesn't know the hidden things, that which is true. But Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala knows that. And it's one of the sunnah, ما فعل في عهد النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم, أن هذا من السنة. وإن لم يضف إلى الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم أن هذا حجة. يقول الشيخ صالح, الشيخ محمد صالح العثيمين in his book الأصول من علم الأصول, what was done at the time of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم and was not objected, even if Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم it was not referred to the Prophet, it was not said Prophet said it, it was not said he did it, it was not said he saw it and he let it go, even it was not said, but yet it happened at the time of Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, we say he said this is hujjah, a proof. Because if it's hidden from Prophet, it's not hidden from who? From Allah Azza wa Jal. Therefore Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned many bad things the munafiqun, hypocrites, were planning, were saying, were doing. Allah mentioned that. So, and that's why the sahabi, he said, Jabir, كنا نعزل والقرآن ينزل. Such used to happen, and the Quran was being sent, was being descend. Quran was being descend. We used to do such and such. Sahabi, he mean it was not stopped. The wahi, the revelation was coming, and we used to do such and such. طيب. So. Barakallahu fiikum. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, if it would have been iyadan billah, as the enemy of Islam claimed, Sahaba they were not truthful, they were this. I'm answering this, I'm saying this because there are people who hear this one, they accept it in an easy way. Allah in a he made a barrier. ولولا إذ سمعتموه ظن المؤمنون والمؤمنات بأنفسهم خيرا. There has to be clear proof. If that gate is open, everyone can be doubt easily. Every believer can easily be said he's not sincere. He's munafiq. As the Khawarij, they say, whoever they want, they say he's not truthful. No, he doesn't believe Islam. But Islam has, there's something clear. Based on that, you judge things. What's hidden is left for Allah. الله يتولى أسرائر ونحن نحكم الظواهر. This is principle. What you see, what you hear, you judge. What's hidden from you, it's not for you. With that, Prophet ﷺ, he mentioned the names of the munafiqun to one of his companions called Hudhayfa. Oh, Hudhayfa, this man you see, that person is munafiq. Allah told me that. Hudhayfa used to be called Sahibu Sirru Rasulillah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The friend, the companion of the secret of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. After Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam died, you know what happened? Umar went to Hudhayfa. He said, Hudhayfa, by Allah, lead messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, include me the munafiqoon. Allahu Akbar. The more you fear Allah, the more you obedient to Allah, the more you pious, you righteous truly, the more you fear Allah. If you find yourself, mashallah, you feel you're doing good, wallahi, you are upon deception. Nothing is wrong with you. You're the one on the straight path. Nothing. There is something wrong with you. There is something wrong with you. Allah mentioned that those who fear of Him are those who قلوبهم وجلت. Their heart fears. Aisha said, O the Messenger of Allah, is those who doing this doing stealing, doing this and fear? He said, no. Rather, they are those who doing this means righteous, yet they fear. So don't think Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he said this or anything but because he fear Allah so much. So he said to Hudhayfa, Unshiduka billah, Unshiduka billah. By Allah, the Messenger of Allah include me the munafiqun. Hudhayfa said, he didn't, and I will not let somebody else know that. I will not answer this question to someone else. I will not, because this gate, this door will be open. Again, he take this sahabi from Prophet ﷺ, Sabaqaka biha ukasha. Naam. So the point is, Prophet ﷺ said, I believe it, and Abu Bakr believe it, and Umar believe it. In this sound hadith, from the most authentic hadith, the level of Abu Bakr and Umar with the Messenger ﷺ. Prophet said, he didn't mention any other sahabi. Abu Bakr believe it, and I believe it. Not Abu Bakr said it, not Umar said it. They believe it, I believe it, and Abu Bakr believe it, Umar believe it. Naam, Ridwan Allah Ta'ala alayhim. So, this is haq, and as the Prophet ﷺ believe it, and his two companions, Abu Bakr and Umar, the rest of the Sahaba believe it, and the true believers believe it, because Prophet ﷺ said it, and whatever Prophet ﷺ said must be truth and haq. And Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala is capable of everything. Allah who make a human being talk can make the sheep talk, wolf talk, the animal talk, the rock talk, the camel talk, the wood talk. All that happened, by the way. Prophet ﷺ mentioned, he said, I know a rock. Stone used to be in Mecca before prophethood. He used to say, Assalamu alaikum to me. Prophet said, I know it now. Before the Prophet, stone used to say to the Prophet, Assalamu alaikum. Yes, Prophet, one time a camel complained to the Prophet about the owner. Prophet, who is the owner? And he mentioned that this camel, she camel is complaining about him. Sahaba, they heard when Prophet ﷺ minbar, which was made of wood, was replaced with the other one, new one, And Prabhupada was moving to that that wood made of a member made of wood, what he did? Crying. Na'am. Rather Allah in the day of judgment will make everything talk. Not only our tongue, our mouth, the skin talk, the hands talk, the feet talk. يوم تشهد عليهم ألسنتهم وأيديهم وأرجلهم بما كانوا يعملون. Rather the earth talk. يومئذ تحدث أخبارها بأن ربك أوحى له. And even in this worldly life, nothing remains but it glorifies Allah. وإن من شيء إلا يسبح بحمده ولكن لا تفقهون تسبيحه. But you don't understand how everything glorify Allah. You don't understand. But it does. It does. So this sun glorifies Allah. The moon, the stars, all this. والنجم والشجر يسجدان. ألم ترى أن الله يسجد له من في السماوات ومن في الأرض والشمس والقمر والنجوم والجبال والشجر والدواب وكثير من الناس وكثير حق عليه العذاب. So these are some of the kuffar, the enemy of Islam. They say, no, how it happened? This, لا. Rather, some أهل البدع, أعوذ بالله, they deny the attributes of Allah. They say, no, no, we don't say Allah has hearing. No, if we say Allah has hearing, we resemble Allah to His creation, to a human being, to those who have ears, hearing, those who have hearing. No, we don't do that. Why you don't do that? Because if we say that, that means that necessitates, like, a'udhu billah, like just what happened to the human being of dust, going to their ears, this we will necessitate if we say Allah has ears, a'udhu billah. So look the, how they make tamthil lillah azza wa jal. That this mic, that's ears, takes my, convey my talk, my voice to how far. It does have his dust of human ears, the tape, the camera, the eyes. Oh, these are, yes, hearing. Doesn't necessarily mean you're hearing, oh, human being. Even the creation don't have the same hearing. Subhanallah. فَمَا بَالُكَ عَيَاذًا بِاللَّهِ بِاللَّهِ الْأَحَدِ الصَّمَدِ الَّذِي لَمْ يَلِدْ وَلَمْ يُولَدْ وَلَمْ يَكُنْ لَهُ كُفُوًا أَحَدٍ. How that Allah is unique. No one resembles Allah. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. Huwa al-Khaliq, the creator, and the rest are al-Makhluq, the creation. How you take example? Yani, so, yes, that wolf talked to the man. And he said that, and Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam believed it because Allah is one who mentioned that to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and the Sahaba. They believed, especially Abu Bakr and Umar. You remember Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala anhu, the night Prophet was ascended to the heaven. It was big fitna to the mushrikun and even to some believers who left Islam because of that incident. When Prophet said in the night time he was taken to Baytul Maqdis, then he was taken to the heaven above the seven heaven. This, they say, how is this possible? Baytul Maqdis takes to us 2 months. 1 month going, 1 month coming back. He claimed that he, in night, he went not only that, even to the seven heaven. So they went, they rushed, the enemy of Islam, rushed to the Sahaba to confuse them. Then they went to Abu Bakr. You know what your friend, your companion said? He said he went all that. Abu Bakr said, if he said that, I believe it. That's why the ulama, they say Abu Bakr had the title of Abu Bakr As-Siddiq. It's where it came from. Abu Bakr As-Siddiq. He trusts so much. And Abu Bakr mentioned the reason. He said, how I don't believe that? I believe that every day and night he gets information from the heaven. From Allah. I mean, it's Allah who gives the information from the heaven. Day and night is capable to take him up. To up. Why you? I already believe something bigger than that. Na'am. Allah qadir ala kulli shay. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala capable of everything. Na'am. and the person is truthful, why I don't believe it? I already had foundations. Now Allah is capable of everything and Prophet is telling the truth. That's these truths I have. After that, everything is very easy to accept it. That if it's sound from Prophet. And this is what a believer should be. Not when a little doubt comes, you question, oh, this is what Islam say? Oh, this is what is there? I don't understand how it is. La ya akhi, don't do that. You have to have foundations to understand it. Na'am, have foundations. Aqeedah, this is the aqeedah, is important. Knowing who the Messenger of Allah is, why he is the Messenger of Allah, what is the proof of him to be وسلم, the Messenger of Allah, why the Quran is the speech of Allah, what is the proof is Quran must be the speech of Allah. If a person understand that, it will be easy to understand the rest. As the Sahaba said, تعلمنا الإيمان ثم تعلمنا القرآن ماذا فازددنا الإيمان. يعني the Sahaba they first learn the إيمان. They say then that we learn Quran, we increase the iman. Naam. So in this hadith again, to say that using the word Subhanallah, glory be to Allah, when you are amazed, Subhanallah, to say it. In the second hadith we've taken from this chapter, inshallah, today, قال الإمام البخاري رحمه الله حدثنا آدم قال حدثنا شعبة عن الأعمش قال سمعت سعد بن عبيدة يحدث. If you want to know the narrators, the biograph of this narrators, حدثنا آدم, who is this آدم, حدثنا شعبة, who is شعبة, what's his name, his father's name, who is أعمش, and the like, go back and take the class of Muhaddithun. The class of Muhaddithun, like the class of Shah Abdul Muhsin, Abbad Hafidahullah. Whenever he comes to this, he mentions, who is this narrator? Who is this? He is this, he is this. Naam. Tayyib. An Abi Abd al-Rahman al-Sulami, an Aliyyin radiallahu anhu, qal, kana al-Nabiyu sallallahu alayhi wa sallam fi janazah, fa'akhada shay'an, faja'ala yankutu bihi fi al-ard. فقال ما منكم من أحد إلا قد كتب مقعده من النار ومقعده من الجنة. قالوا يا رسول الله أفلا نتكل على كتابنا وندع العمل؟ قال اعملوا فكل ميسر لما خلق له. قال أما من كان من أهل السعادة فسيسر لعمل السعادة, وأما من كان من عمل الشقاوة فسيسر لعمل الشقاوة. ثم قرأ فأما من أعطى واتقى وصدق بالحسنى. أيضا الحديث أخرجه البخاري في كتاب الأدب, والإمام مسلم أيضا في كتاب القدر. حديث نمبر 903. علي, may Allah be pleased with him, علي رضي الله تعالى عنه, said the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was in a funeral procession, jazakallahu khair, and he sallallahu alaihi wasallam took something and began to scratch the ground with it, like a little wood, and began to scratch the ground with it. He said, there is no one but has his place written for him, either in the fire or in the garden, the Jannah. They said, Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, then should we not rely on our book and leave action? He sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, act. It's easy. It's easy for someone to do something for which he was created. He, father sallallahu alaihi wasallam, said, as for someone who is among the people of happiness, it's easy for him to do the actions of happiness. As for someone who is one of the people of wretchedness, it is easy for him to do the actions of wretchedness. Then he, sallallahu alaihi wasallam, recited, as for the one who gives and is fearful and conscious of Allah and confirms the good. This verse in Surah Al-Layl. This hadith is about why Imam Bukhari wrote this hadith under this chapter. Where is the word Subhanallah? طيب, in this hadith, Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said that everyone is placed in the paradise or in the Jannah is written. Everyone is positioned. Whatever people will enter of Jannah or to fire, iyadan billah, is written. Then the Sahaba, they said, O the Messenger of Allah, if this is the case, why don't we don't rely on the book and leave the actions? If this is the case, whatever we will be is written already of Jannah or hellfire, then why we don't leave off of the Messenger of Allah, the actions? We don't rely on, why we don't rely on the book? Prophet ﷺ said, I'malu, act. فَكُلٌ مُيَسَّرٌ لِمَا خُلِقٌ. Everyone will be made easy for that which he was created for. As for the one from the people of happiness, will be made easy for him the actions of the sa'ada, happiness. As for the one who is from the people of shaqawa, نعم, those who lose, will be made easy for him the path, the actions of the Ash-Shaqawa. Then the Prophet ﷺ recited the ayah in Surah Al-Layl, as for the one who gives and has taqwa and believe the tawheed, la ilaha illallah bil husna, also other tafsir was given, Allah said, will made easy for him, يعني the easy one. As for the one, amma man bakhila wa staghna wa kadhaba bil husna, as for the one who make bukhul, he doesn't give it, and he belie the husna, the tawheed, he will make easy for him the difficult one. Naam. So in this hadith, there are a lot of lessons. One lesson is that believe in the decree, that all our actions, not only now, even what we will end to, of Jannah or Paradise, for everyone is written. Is written. Allahu alimu bi kulli shay. And believing the decree is one of the pillars of Iman, foundations of Iman. Without believing the Qadr, no Salah, no fasting, no Hajj, nothing. لأن هذا من أصول الإيمان. And that Sahabi, when the group call Al-Qadariya, those who deny the Qadr, say nothing was written. With the first time they came from Basra, city in Iraq, as in Sahih Muslim, and that was informed to Ibn Umar that such people come out saying Al-Amru Unuf, everything is beginning now, nothing was written. He said, tell them, I'm free from them, they free from me. And nothing will be accepted from them until they believe it. Then he mentioned Hadith Jibreel. Prophet ﷺ was asked by Angel Jibreel, tell me about Iman. One of it, وَتُؤْمِنَ بِالْقَدَّرِ خَيْرِهِ وَشَرِّهِ. So to believe the Qadr. The people of knowledge mentioned Qadr has four pillars. Number one, to know, to believe Allah knows everything. Number two, to believe that Allah wrote down that knowledge. Number three, to believe that Allah made those things happen. He created Azza wa Jal. And number four, to believe that everything takes place with the Mashia of Allah, the willing of Allah. In detail, don't get confused. If you have these principles, you believe the Qadr. If you want to learn much, more just go only by the revelation. Anything other than that, أمسك. إذا ذكر القدر فأمسكه. If the decree is mentioned, be quiet. Means if the decree is mentioned in a wrong way or based on opinion and thoughts, be quiet. Don't go that. نعم. As the hadith, إذا ذكر أصحابي فأمسكه. If my companion are mentioned, be silent. Means if the companion are, if bad is mentioned about the companion, be quiet. But if good is mentioned, هذا حق هذا دين رضي الله عنهم ورضوا عنهم. So to believe the قدر. طيب. And the hadith, the Sahaba رضوان الله تعالى عليهم, when they heard this, that everything was written, this question came out. Then what is the point? What is the wisdom behind making actions if it's written? This question is so much today, people they ask. So rather you may advise one brother, Akhi, fear Allah, why are you doing this? He asks a question. Whatever I will be, is it written or not? Yes, it's written. Is it ghalas? From the people of Jannah, I will be anywhere from people of Jannah. People of fire, I will be anywhere of fire. Okay, la. This one is wrong. To know that what's written is what you do in it. What was written is what you do in it. Nothing else was written. So you choose what you want to be written. What Allah wrote down is what we will do it. Not different. If you do good, that's what's written. If you do bad, that's what's written. We have to have some understanding of what the qadr is. What's written is what we are doing it willingly, with our willing, with our option, with our anything other than that is not going to be against us. Even if it happened. If your car breaks down, this is musibah. You didn't do that, it's written, but you don't take the responsibility. Unlike if you do that intentionally. So what we will hold accountable is what we do willingly, knowingly. Na'am. So person to do what he wants. وَقُلِ الْحَقُّ مِنْ رَبِّكُمْ فَمَنْ شَاءَ فَلْيُؤْمِنْ وَمَنْ شَاءَ فَلْيَكْفُرْ. نعم. Not the understanding, the opposite, that what's written is something and what you do is another thing. So regardless what you do, what's written is different. لا. What's written is what you do in it. نعم. So to do, and the Prophet ﷺ, he recited the ayah. Whoever does this, does this, does this, does this, will be led to the good, to the ease. Whoever does this, does this, does this, will be led to the difficult. So ending up to the difficult is a cause of doing this. Ending up to the yusra, to the jannah, to the paradise, there is because of these actions. So these actions were before entering jannah. Before you enter the jannah, you did the actions of the jannah. Before you enter the hellfire, you did the action of hellfire. Hellfire was not number one, was the last. The hellfire came on the consequence, on the result of the actions. وَتِلْكَ الْجَنَّةُ الَّتِي أُورِثْتُمُوهَا بِمَا كُنْتُمْ تَعْمَلُونَ. This is the jannah you inherit, O believers, because of what you used to do it. نعم. So, knowing the qadr shouldn't lead to live of the righteous actions. Rather to do it more. The more you believe the qadr truly, the more you act better and you perfect your actions. Because you know it's what's written. So after Allah, it's in your hand, whatever you write for yourself. As the hadith of Qudsi, إِنَّمَا عِبَادِي إِنَّمَا هِيَ أَعْمَالُكُمْ أُحْصِيهَا لَكُمْ ثُمَّ أُوَفِّيهَا إِيَّاكُمْ فَمَنْ وَجَدَ خَيْرًا فَلْيَحْمَدِ اللَّهِ ومن وجد غير ذلك فلا يلومن الا نفسه. In that hadith of Qudsi, Allah mentioned it is our actions. Allah collects it for us. Whoever gets good, he should thank Allah. Whoever gets the opposite, he shouldn't blame anyone but himself. So it's أعمالكم, it's your own actions. من عمل صالحا فلنفسه ومن أساء فعليها. Yes, the ulama, they say the qadr, the decree you use for the calamities, which you have nothing to do with it. Tornado came, remove your car. Break the tire. Akhi, what happened to you? قدر الله وما شاء فعل. The decree of Allah. هذا حق. Okay? But you go and you steal the money in somebody's wallet. Akhi, why you did it? قدر الله. لا. كلمة حق أريد بها بعض. It's true. It's a قدر of Allah. But you misplacing it. You wanna defend, you wanna justify your evil action, which you did it because of Qadr. And the first one who did that was Iblis. قال ربي بما أغويتني لأزينن لهم في الأرض ولا أغوين أجل. Oh Allah, because you misguide me, I will do such and such. Yes, it's true. Iblis couldn't do anything but what Allah decreed, what Allah will. الإرادة الكونية ليس إرادة شرعية. Universal command, not religious command. نعم, Allah is one who gave the option, the Iblis, the human being, to do the good or to do the bad. In this, everything is under the will of Allah. نعم, so this, but Iblis, he misused the Qadr. So anyone who doing haram and he want to justify the sin because the decree, he's on the path of Iblis. You use the Qadr on something you have nothing to do with it. Naam, somebody he regularly drive. The highway, the street is 35. He driving 1/10. No seatbelt. Car tire is already breakdown. Okay. Then something happened. قدر الله. لا. Yes, it's قدر الله because you the cause. But when you make everything, oil change, seat belt, say Bismillah, okay, you follow the guidelines which was made for the benefit, for the safety of you and the rest, توكلت على الله, Bismillah, and then somebody sleep, other car, it's not even you. He went off the highway, he hit you. Now you say قدر الله. Okay, you understand? So the قدر of Allah, you use it as excuse, you use it for the calamities, المصائب, لا المعايب, not for the weaknesses and the shortcoming and the negligence from you. نعم. If you don't work, you don't take the means, you don't work. Lazy, sleeping, snoring, all day, all night. Don't want to work. Then people ask you, why are you poor? You say, قدر الله. نعم, قدر الله. But you misusing the word. It is you who didn't take the means. You have to take the means. Umar said, السماء لا تمطر ذهبا. The sky doesn't rain a gold. Means look for the gold. So, قدر الله with Allah decree عز وجل, نعم, this will take place and person should know when to use to as excuse and when not to use it. والله أعلم, وصلى الله وسلم على نبينا محمد وآله وصحبه أجمعين. Someone was raising his hand. Okay. سبحانك اللهم بحمدك, لا إله إلا أنت, نستغفرك ونتوب إليك.